Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. I'm actually coming back to you after a long time. Not a long time, I guess it is a long time. I've been away for about a fortnight or so. And the primary reason for that was that my girlfriend, my long-distance girlfriend, she came over to visit me. And needless to say, I wanted to give us most of my time. So, I mean, it's not like we get to see each other every other day. Oh, another show. Yeah, so anyway. Moving on, I'm also streaming the game for the first time today, and it is my first live stream today. I don't know whether I'm gonna get any viewers or not, but well, let's hope that I do. Anyway, enough dilly-dallying around, I suppose, beating around the bush, if you will. Today's task at hand is to go over to Murkwood and raid the hell out of that place. So without further ado, let's go. Black Marsh and Murkwood. 13 days. You know, I sure hope that my skills are at par. Screenshot time. Murkwood. The mists of Murkwood, the black forests, swirl about. Inside the dark forest can be heard faint cries of despair. Souls who have lost their ways within its cunning web. Though the smell of decay flows from every tree and stone, within this forest lies the seventh piece of the Staff of Chaos. So, I can't feel it? I mean, this place does sort of look desolate and dead, but oh well, I guess that's just what the game is. So no entry ambush, thankful for that. I'm just gonna save the game here, because that's how you play Arena, as I have discussed previously as well. Let me just raise the volume and check whether I am equipping the Rex Sword. It looks like I have the Ebony Longsword equipped currently, but yeah, you know what, I'm just gonna keep it that way, and I mean, I will still have the Ebony Broadsword to fall back on once I'm done with this, so... Well, this place looks lovely, doesn't it? The map won't go any more north, so I guess that's... So, we come up near the near the northeast entrance. Ah, fuck my pronunciation. I haven't been talking to a lot of people for a long time. Ooh. Yeah, I guess that is the way back up. That is how it usually is. I would probably be dying a lot. The Mist of Murkwood curl up around you, behind you, blinding you from danger and confusing your sense of direction. I heard something. And my skills are not at par right now, so I would probably be dying a lot. Like, just take this instance here. I mean, I was still on time in this case, but in most cases I probably won't. But yeah, I mean, one of the things which I don't really like about this game is fire. Yeah, so one of the things which I don't really like about this game is how the enemies just sneak up on you and how they're designed to blend into the environment. And to add on top of that, they can insta-kill you. So yeah, I mean, if you ask me, that sort of sucks. Well, I guess I could just save it for the time being. And we have it right now. I mean, at least the place is broad. It just adds more to the confusion. Am I going the right way? I do not know. This just looks like... what was that again? Elden Grove, yeah. Elden Grove 2.0. I mean, there's a lot of wandering around. I mean, this place is even larger than Elden Grove was. At least Elden Grove had comparatively narrower passages. Ouch, I completely forgot to heal. See, that's what I'm talking about when I'm saying that my skills are not on point right now. For example, right now I would have turned instead. I should have turned and I would have turned if it was the, you know, a fortnight old me playing the game instead of me right now. But yeah, I didn't, because my skills have gone rusty, and that's how fast my skills deteriorate. Hey, the spiders, I was like killing you guys. You guys are so hassle free. I don't really think these guys called for a save. Okay, huh. This place looks expansive, but at the same time, there doesn't really seem to be much else to this place. You can hear sounds like heavy breathing through the mists, from which it becomes impossible. Just a moment. Yeah, let me pop in another resist shock and dispose of these guys. The resist element potions in this game really, really help you out. I mean, okay, where was the message again? Through the mist, but direction from which it come, from which it came, okay, is impossible to determine. Fuck my pronunciation. Yeah, I mean, the game doesn't have 3D audio. Of course, it would be impossible to determine which direction the heavy breathing came from. Yeah, I do not exactly want to save the game there. I was about to save, but then I heard these guys. And every time you can, like, instead of lining them up, you want to line up melee attackers. But every time you get some ranged attackers, make sure that you've got as many of them before you as you can. That way, it's just easier to kill them. And they can't get to you with the ranged attacks, so yeah. Looks like I'm not even halfway done with this place. But hey, at least I'm on the rightmost corner. Excuse me. It has started, the cold has started falling, I guess? I mean, it has started to become cold where I live here. And yeah, I'm just mildly under the weather, as I usually keep. Okay. That sounded like a hellhound. Something I need to be cautious about, lest I wish to die. Nothing usable. Because hellhounds. Okay, so this was like a complete loop. Uh-huh. Okay. Excuse me. I guess I'll just go this way then. That two ghouls. Ghouls are easy. I mean, by the time that you reach my level 17, or like even before that, and if you've got the proper equipment, ghouls are pretty easy. They aren't so difficult. What is difficult, however, is this place is getting more and more mazy. I think I'll just update my save, just for the sake of it, just for the sake of preserving the progress we have made thus far. You really need to save in the... Wait, weren't we going... Yeah, we were... Wait, what? Yeah, we were... Oh, so there's a way to go... No, there isn't. I guess I should check... Oh shit, this guy just scared me. Good thing I had the ebony blade like equipped, otherwise... these creatures, you can't kill them with any other sort of blade. And they do take a long time to die, but at least they do die, so I am thankful for that. And resist fire as well. This calls for another save. Comes the sound of drums. Oh, so there are actually are drums in this place. I thought it was just for show. This is an interesting take on the place. It just turned from a hedge maze into a stone maze. I don't mind exploring a little when I can. Wait, somebody took a swipe at me, didn't they? Or maybe it was a ranged attack, because my health just dropped. By just a teensy-weensy bit, but it sure did drop. Oh, there's a door here. I wonder how we can get there. Let me see. Perhaps I can wrap around. Let me just save the game here, just in case. I have to take the path on the right, right? Yeah. No, there isn't any way from that. Is that Medusa? I am paralyzed. Of course I am. But why does she sound... Why does naked Medusa sound like skeletons? No idea. Anyway, Okay, so potion of reaction. Wait, there are two Medusas here. Easy there. Whoa. Seriously, come on. Heal true? Yeah, I'm sorry guys, I'm being super slow with all of this, but yeah, you can consider me a returning gamer, if you will. So yeah, I don't really think I need anything else right now. Okay, I guess that was in the nick of time. Another one. I am going to need another potion of heal true. Well, at least does Medusa have something for me then? I guess not. There were two Medusas. One had a katana. One has an amulet, yes. So... That was a difficult battle. But hey, it looks like the way inside is right here. And one of the easier ways to access it would be through this place here? I'm guessing, I don't really know. I mean, it doesn't hurt to check, does it? I mean, I do have to save the game right now anyway, so... Middle of nowhere it is. Because we literally are there. In the middle of nowhere. Wait, what? Where did it just... Ah, yeah. And I really did not expect to find the way... deeper into the dungeon so easily. But, here we are, I guess. Let's, Okay, another fire dragon. Not a fire dragon, like a fire demon. Do I need to... Let's just use one for the sake of it. It's safer this way, isn't it? I swear, I mean, I didn't stream the last time, but I did upload it on YouTube because that is primarily what I plan to do. I plan to upload my games on YouTube instead of streaming them. But, I mean, I thought that, you know, if I might as well just stream the game anyway. It doesn't really sound like such a bad idea. But yeah, the last playthrough, I literally had to sell a lot of my stuff just so that I could get enough gold. I see. I was going the correct way. So we wrap around this area here. Wait, straight for now. I heard something, but I'm not really all too eager to stay and engage it. For more or less obvious reasons, I would say. Can I? Yeah, thank you. Okay, take the path on the right. The hairs on the back of your neck rises. Okay, cool it there, cool it. Heal true, okay. Now I can face you. Keep a hand on the U button, and keep another hand on the arrow buttons, and forget about attacking. The way you have to attack in this game is you literally... Okay, at least nobody's gonna catch me here, I hope, hopefully. Not empty, I think it's, this is this one's turn. Anyway, so the way you attack in this game is you hold down the right click button. First you need to equip your sword using this button here or the A button. And you hold down your right click button and you swing. And having a finger span which reaches from the arrow keys all the way over to the U key. I mean, you can flip the keys here, but on my keyboard especially, but... Okay, to pass this portal, answer my riddle. But yeah, anyway, I'll get to this shortly. You can hold the, switch the WASD keys with the, you know, the arrow keys in my keyboard. But, even if I do that, it doesn't really help my cause. And shifting all the way over from either the WASD or the arrow keys over to the U button, which is the only button for you to actually equip something, is a very difficult task. You literally need to lift your hand up and quickly hit that one button that, you know, that can save your life in the event of an encounter. But yeah, anyway, I digress. To pass this portal, answer my riddle. I tie and hold, capture and bind, yet both knights and knaves doth crave me. I faithfully enslave all within my grasp, whether or not they seek me, yet those who have never felt my unmerciful hand are pitied by their fellow man. You know, it's quite ironic. I have the answer. And it is quite ironic. I did think of this answer. I really did think of this answer, but for some reason it just slipped out of my mind and it never re-entered it again. And I completely forgot about it. I completely forgot to try it out. And apparently the answer is love. It just makes so much sense. Love it is. Thou hast found the answer. Proceed into the heart of Murkwood. Can I save you? I would like to save you, please. Thank you. Level 2. There's something glowing inside there. Ooh, is that... Yeah, that is a piece of the Staff of Chaos, isn't it? Okay, now what shenanigans does this thing have here? Let me just re-save here. Okay, you can see what looks to be a piece of stuff. You can see, okay, I guess I'll just read that during, you know, editing. You can see what looks to be a piece of the staff directly ahead. From around you come strange screeching sounds like iron being twisted and bent again and again. Okay, there are some crevices here. And tell me again, why can't I just use a potion of levitation to go get across and fetch that thing over there? Wait, isn't there a door there? I mean, I can certainly see a door. You know what, I'm just gonna try it. I'm going to pop in a potion of levitation. A simple riddle for some, a trap of eternity for others. Excuse me. I run smoother than any rhyme, I love to fall but cannot climb. I tremble at each breath of air, and yet can heaviest burdens bear. What is thy answer? Okay. Now I wonder how water can bear heavy burdens. I mean, it can't. Heavy things sink in water. But, okay, I mean, if that's what you say it is, thou art truly worthy of the prize. Proceed, mortal, and leave in peace. Sure. The seventh piece attaches itself to the rest of the staff, infusing it with a fiery glow that only dims slightly in time. Well, I guess I'll just take my leave then. There's no real point in me staying here now that I already have the Staff of Chaos, so... I mean, what I could do is probably, you know, explore a bit more of this place. I could try, you know, exploring this side. It seems like I haven't really explored this side, like, at all. So, I guess I'll just map out this area as I leave and, yeah, let's see what happens. Okay, where are you, you winged bugger? Okay, excuse me. Yeah, thank you. potion of resist shock. But what was that? That sounded like it was something. Anyway, I'll just take this cue to save again, because, well, you need to save a lot in this game. If you want to survive, that is. I am paralyzed, seriously. How can something paralyze me from behind? I mean, unless it's a spider. Free action, can I move? Nope, it was two Medusas. Again, I'm paralyzed again. I'll heal first and then I'll free my own action. Heal, please. I mean, as a warrior or like as a melee combatant, the game can be pretty boring at times when all you have to do is just stand at one place and swing your sword around. Because, I mean, this game is more or less chance-based. The combat in this game is chance-based, so you can't exactly expect to, you know, dodge their attacks or anything. As long as you're in range, which is actually quite a long range, as long as you're in range, they will get you. So, braces, I'll take the braces. Dark shield, I mean, I haven't found any loot in this place anyway, so I guess I'll just take the tower shield as well. And save. Figures materialize out of the mist. Oh, this was a dead end, how lovely. Is there anything here? No, that's where we came from, didn't we? Or did we? There seems to be a way back through here, so I guess I'll just try that out. Comes the sound of drums. Yes, I did notice the first time around as well. Where am I going again? I just hope that I don't deviate too far. Oh shit. Sometimes this game just gives you straight on jump scares, and yeah, this was one of those moments. Yeah, I don't think I can use any resist potions against this naked woman here, so Medusa. She's supposed to be like the seducer of all men, but yeah, apparently not. She looks fucking ugly to me. I don't know, I mean, some people might be interested in that sort of stuff, but you do you, I guess. 76 gold pieces, amazing! A talk, cut shield. And I shall take that opportunity to save again. You can never save enough in this game. What? See? Oh! I see! It's a ranged attack. It's Medusa's ranged attack that paralyzes you, and all the while I was thinking that it's her. Wait, the potion failed. Yeah, all the while I was thinking that it's probably her. What do you call it? Where is it? Yeah, right here. It's her sight, it's her looking at you that sort of paralyzes you. But here's what's gonna happen. If this part takes me along a more roundabout way, then I shall seize the pursuit of this part and 171 gold pieces! Amazing! Okay. Then I shall seize the pursuit of this part and I shall return back the way I came from. And yeah, this is a much longer winding path. More longer and more winding than it needs to be. So I'll just take the path that I'm familiar with again. Which would be this one. I don't really see this path taking me anywhere. So we go back where we came from. Another fire team. Ah, yes, I forgot. These guys get respawned. These guys get respawned every time you come to attack them, like every time you change the level or re-enter the dungeon or basically do anything. Somebody threw something at me. While I would really like to hold you accountable, whoever you are, it was you. I was about to say escaping is a bigger priority of mine, but as long as you're going to present a crotch to me, I'm gonna hack it up with a sword. So. Half of this game is literally just pausing the game and using up potions. And I better use a potion of resist fire because there are some hellhounds and other things which can insta-kill me here. Wait, where am I? Am I in the wrong place? Ah, I am. I guess this is the way out then. I suppose I could. Well, I guess I'll just do that then. It's a maze, isn't it? I mean, as long as I stick to the left side, I should be getting out at some point in time, right? What the fuck, man? So many fire demons, come on! I mean, if it was something else, I wouldn't, you know, be so pissed about it, but You guys literally don't leave me anything. See, you just disappear. You just fuck off into nowhere in a blaze of fire. And you don't even give me anything. It's so unrewarding fighting these guys. But anyway, I'm just whining. Yes, I know, I've already accomplished what I came here for. And we shall now retrace our steps until we can get out of this mess. Was it this one? No, it was not. And this isn't really anything either. I guess I'll... Should I? No, I just did save, so... No need to save again. Is this the way? Certainly seems to be. I shall take it. Half of the game is pausing the game to open your inventory, half of it is pausing the game to open your fucking map. And it seems to be a pretty straightforward shot from here. Well, I guess I shall update... Why do I even bother? 32 gold pieces, good enough. Yeah, I guess I'll update my dungeon escape save here. And I shall use... Nah, I shall wait a little longer. Straight shot. Just confirming it. Yeah, straight shot. So my one stream viewer... Ah, wolves. A nice change of pace after a long time, honestly. I just hope there aren't any hellhounds here. That would suck. But yeah, to my one stream viewer, my apologies. Fuck my pronunciation. My apologies that I don't have my face cam on, but I don't exactly have a proper setup here, and as you can probably tell already, am I going the right way? No, I just overshot it. Yeah. I overshot the entrance. Awesome! Mission accomplished. So where do we want to go now? Seaspring? I guess we can go to Seaspring. So yeah, I don't exactly have the correct considering your condition. No, I do not. I forgot. I completely forgot about it. Excuse me. I need to heal first. I mean, right now I'm diseased, so I have cholera. So what I need to do is I need to use a potion of purification. Yeah, thank you. I'll just update the dungeon escape save once again. And you know, the last playthrough I made the silliest of mistakes of not picking up the objective that I went into raid. You know, like, oh yeah, I've got 7 star pieces, so I did not commit that same mistake this time around. And yeah, I guess we'll just go over to Seaspring. It's a good thing that they showed you that warning message though. I like that. Funky sounds. You have arrived in the town of Seaspring in Black Marsh Province. The date is low dust, 12th of first frostfall in the year. Third era 390. It took 2 days to reach your goal. You walk through the gates of Black Marsh, ruled by Baroness Demetra. The street seems strangely quiet. Okay, I thought it was just me. Let me just lower the volume on my end a little bit. Yeah, the game has clear volume balancing issues. It can get super loud at times. And, I guess that's pretty much all there was to today's episode, if you will. I mean, it was a short stream, I suppose. Where is the nearest store? Okay, southeast of here. And where is the nearest inn? Why don't I just inscribe the exact location on your map? How polite of you. Thank you. The Blue Dungeon. Okay, nice name for an inn, I guess. So yeah, to my one subscriber, whoa, this place is huge. I guess I understand why they call it a dungeon. Anyway, to my one subscriber, I don't exactly have a proper setup here right now, so yeah. I will probably be using a face cam and other things soon enough. And here he is, the infamous fapping man. Okay, time to grab a drink. I guess I'll grab a stout. Stout is my favorite thing to drink in real life, so yeah. And I shall be getting a room, a single. Just one day, not more. No, I don't care, really. I mean, there's once a time that I would have bargained with him over it, but right now I don't really care. We have a lady over there. Okay, so what's the time right now? 3:10 in the afternoon? I guess I'll sleep for how many hours? 24 minus 9, 15. Camp for a while, 15 hours. And this is the moment I've been waiting for. The Dream Bridge of Riesel Lane. I would take my chances, Grimfangs, for Tharn has no mercy and will attack the moment he perceives himself reassembled. You must be swift. To the northeast lies... next, please. Yeah. Fire Mountain Dagoth Ur. Somewhere in its volcanic depths is the final piece of the Staff of Chaos. The entrance to that fabled mountain has disappeared with the dwarves that built the place. Mind it. Okay. I think they built it and they lived there. I mean, Dagoth Ur was supposed to be made out of Lorkhan's heart, but, yeah, I guess, I don't know, I'll just have to check it up. But, yeah. There may still be those who know of it, however... Oh yeah, those who know of it, however. Find the entrance, enter the volcanic catacombs, and return with the final piece of the staff. We are so close, I wish you well. Thank you, Rhea. I guess that is all I have for you guys today. Yeah. Thanks for watching. Until next time, take care, farewell for all things. And that's pretty much the cue for me to stop my... Today's the 13th of Frostfall, known throughout Tamriel as the Witches' Festival, when the forces of sorcery and religion clash. The Mage's Guild gets most of the business since weapons and items are evaluated for their mystic potential, free of charge, and magic spells are one half their usual price. Demonologists, conjurers, lamiers, warlocks, and thaumaturgists meet in the wilderness outside Seaspring. The creatures created or summoned there may plague Tamriel for aeons. Most wise men choose not to wander this night.